Galatians chapter 5, verses 19 to 22. We'll be reading the full verse, right? The whole of this all together. Galatians chapter 5, verses 19 to 22. Right? Kung may mga Bibles po kayo, markahan niyo po yan. Maganda pong verse yan. Right? 19 to 22. Okay, to 23 pala. 19 to 23. Alright, nandiyan na po kayo? Alright, we're gonna read all together. Dahan-dahan lang po, alright? Para hindi po mabilis masyado yung pagbabasa natin at maintindihan po natin. Alright, reading now. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, immorations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envyings, murders, drunkenness, rebellions, and such like. Of that, as I have also told you in time past, that they that do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. Okay, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Let us bow our heads. Dakila at mapagpalang Diyos, thank you, O God, for today. Thank you for bringing us here. We are so glad, O God, that we can hear your word tonight. And I just pray, O God, that open our hearts, O God, and our minds, that we can understand and absorb na anumang preaching ngayong araw na ito, O God, that we can apply this in our lives, O God. Lord, I pray also that you give me wisdom, O God, as I preach by word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, you may be seated. Good morning po. So, good morning ulit. Ako yung biglang kinabahan because I have to speak English again. So our topic for the full month of our emphasis is about gentleness. Right? If I try to read, alright, about gentleness, and most of the books that I have read is they will give you a quick fix, right? Say yung buhay, yung sabi natin quick fix, and it will not last long. So, pangandalian lang ang ibig sabihin nun. And as I read the Bible, right, so as I read, yung hinahanap ko also these questions, right, about gentleness and how, paano mo ba mababago yung buhay mo? How you will have all this virtue na nakalagay po dyan, right? So, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy. How can you have all of this love and joy and long suffering, alright, and gentleness kasama po dyan. So I'm trying to search for that, and I remember yung isang preaching when we are back in the Philippines at before you understand na malaman kung ano yung gentleness or about this fruit of the Spirit, you must see this in the context of growth. Ano po ba yung growth? Huh? Growth, ibig sabihin, tumalayo, tumalaki, di ba? The context of growth. Titingnan natin sa tree, di ba? The tree starts with a seed. And then, yayabong yan, right? Magkakaroon ng, tawag na? Sprout. Right? And then it will start to have stem, branches, and then leaves, and so on and so forth. And at the moment na he's that mature, you will see that there is a fruit. So, yan po ang, that is what we are going to look today. And if you could see, if you see yourself, no, kung ikaw, yung gentleness kasi parang isip natin, we are sometimes gentle only to those persons who are kind to us, or we are nakikinabang tayo sa kanila, or may gusto tayo sa kanila. Diba? That is, sabi natin, tao eh, no? But Kaya nga po kung titingnan nyo, if you are a victim, ito, puso-puso sa Pilipinas, if you are a victim of this Tanimbala gang, or Tanimbala syndicate, do you think you will be gentle with this person na alam mo siya yung nagkanin ng bala? Hindi, di ba? You will not be gentle na ikikare mo pa, baka, hindi eh, baka batukan mo yan eh. Kung pira, nawalan ako ng trabaho dahil sa'yo, di ba? So, yung gentleness, kuminsan, it affects yung mga nangyayari sa atin. Naapektuhan tayo sa mga nangyayari. So, yun ang hanapin natin. Ano ba yung, what is the true gentleness or the, yung sasabi nila, ang title ng message ko nga is, title of our message is, how to have a true and lasting gentleness. Paano ka ba magkakaroon ng yung totoong gentleness ba? That it will not be affected by those things that surrounds you. It will not be affected by your feelings. Okay? So, yun ang pag-aaral natin. And, sample din.
Okay, if
your son or daughter, no? Or your daughter na lang, na-rape yan, do you think magiging gentle ka pa ba dun sa taong nag-rape dun sa anak mo? Hindi po, di ba? And, in contrast, sa tao na mabait sa'yo, di ba napakadali? It's so easy for us to be gentle to those person who are kind to us, or maybe your boss is kind to you. You are gentle to him or to her. But if your boss is a crazy boss, you will not be gentle. Maybe dadagog-dagog ka pa, may sasagot-sagot ka pa, di ba? So, yun ang ating pag-uusapan ngayon, how to have gentleness. Maybe sabihin natin, naging rason ng tao, tao lang po ako eh. I am human. If someone does wrong or did something wrong to me, of course, my initial reaction is magagalit ako or ganun eh. Ganun rason ng tao. But think of it, if that is Jesus Christ, will He give the same answer as yours? Will you give the same answers? Hindi, di ba? And that is not also according to what this Bible says. Yeah? Ipinag-aralan natin ito at hindi yan ang prinsipyo po ng Bible. And especially, you will say that I accepted the Lord Jesus Christ and I am a follower of the Lord Jesus Christ. Pero bakit ganun po ang pag-iisip natin? At bakit po ganun ang reaction po ng tao sa mga ganung sitwasyon? Now, that is what we are going to study. How to have that long and lasting gentleness. At ang sagot po niya, nandiyan po sa text natin. It is in our text. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness. Nandiyan po yung gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Yan po yung fruit po yan ng Espiritu. So, yan po yung pretty ko, tapos na. Makukuha niyo ang gentleness kapag mayroon kayong fruit of the Spirit. Yun po yung pinakasagot eh. Pero kapag tatanungin mo ngayon, even most, maybe some of you are all-time attenders team, if I ask you now, how you will get that fruit of the Spirit, maybe mahirapan po tayong sagutin yan, di ba? How you will get that fruit of Spirit? Paano mo mabuhay yan? Is it like that I accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior and have the fruit of the Spirit? Ganun lang po ba? Hindi, di po ba? Hindi. And that is what we are going to study today. At pag-aralan natin what are the levels na dapat natin maabot o ano yung steps na gagawin natin in order for us to have that fruit of the Spirit. And, of course, you will have gentleness. And the good thing in here is, once you have reached that level or that progress in your spiritual life, you will not only have gentleness, you will also have love, joy, alright? Pakibalik ko yan. Long-suffering, gentleness, lahat po yan magkakasama. Hindi po yung gusto ko magkaroon lang ako ng gentleness eh. Kaya mo na yung peace kasi may kaaway ka sa church. Hindi po. Sabi po dyan, but the fruit, isa lang yan, isa. Isa, isa lang yan. Hindi po sinabi, but the fruits, hindi po eh. Nakalagay po dyan, but the fruit. So you cannot have gentleness unless you are having goodness or long-suffering. So magkakasama po yan. Andun sa good thing, di ba? Isang buwan na lang, ano? Makukuha ko pala yung gentleness, makukuha ko rin pala lahat. So yun po nga yung pag-aralan. Paano po tayo makakaabot yan? How we will reach that stage sa buhay natin bilang isang mananampalataya in order for us to have that gentleness. I would say I am not that gentle siguro, no? But I am more gentle now than before.
Amen.
Siguro sa inyo mga lalaki matatapang lang tayo minsan sa nakalikod. Ako matapang ako, hindi ako nagsasalita. Sinasapag ko yung kasama ko sa trabaho. Kaya kung luluko-luko kayo dito, hindi na po. Gentle na po ako ngayon. When I was not a Christian, even that time, I accepted the Lord Jesus Christ that time, no? And I am only, I think, 1 month na Christian. So, I don't know about fruit of the Spirit. I don't know about this Holy Spirit or anything of this. Because I'm only 1 month. Kaya, the one Egyptian came to me, my office mate. He's speaking in Arabic. Right? He's speaking in Arabic and he thought that I don't understand Arabic. So he's speaking against me. So I just stand up and spank him. Yeah, so, gano'n na lang. And yung mukha niya tumama sa lamesa ko. Simula. Mas maliit siya eh. Kung mas malaki kayo, yun yung isip-isip ako. Pero mas maliit siya eh. Kaya nung mas maliit siya, nakikita ko, pingin ako. So, that time, sabihin ko, wala kong gentleness. Diba? Nandun po kasi yung, yan o, sinasabi dyan sa una, now the works of the flesh, nandyan po kasi sa akin dati, mga ganyan, strife, no? Nandyan po yung works of the flesh, mas malakas ang aking flesh that time. But, praise God dahil pinabago niya tayo through the Word of God. And that is also what I want to, no, share to you, how we can get, para mo na makakuha itong fruit of the Spirit. Now, first thing that we need to have is you must be born again. Or you should be born of the Spirit. Right? So, yeah.
Buksan po natin sa
John chapter 1 to 15. Alright? Just open your Bible in John 1 to 15. I'll read it for you. Okay, just follow me as I read it to you. Ye must be born again. Okay? Born of the Spirit. All of us here, na you accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, na totoo in your heart. Alright? Alam mo. Okay? Ikaw ay saved. Yan po ang nangyari sa atin. You are born again. In sa John chapter 1 to 15, sabi po dyan, open ba brad?
Mayroon ba ako? Wala. Mayroon? Ano kalagay?
Okay. Sa John 3 to 6, okay, I just have quoted 3 to 6, okay. Ito po yung kwento. This is the passage when one Jew called Nicodemus. You know Nicodemus, ito sabi, Nicodemus is a Pharisee, he's a ruler of the Jew. Except he's a rich guy, he's a very influential guy, and he is also a teacher. Ibig sabihin, he teach in the synagogues, si Nicodemus. At this person, he may gumugulo sa isip niya. There's something in his mind that is bothering him. That's why he went to Jesus Christ, he came by night, alright, kasi sisitayin siya, gabi, kasi baka magkita siya ng ibang Jew or ibang Pharisee na nag-ipag-usap kay Jesus Christ. Actually, these Pharisees, those Pharisees ang nag-condemn kay Jesus Christ para, di ba? Ikulong yan, bis na pinagpili sila, di ba? Mga Pharisee yung mga yun. Ngayon, ito ang sagot ni Jesus Christ sa kanya. Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Now, your perception to our visit, first time na, that we have na nakapunta rito or sa mga bago, maybe your perception of born again is a religion. No, it's not. Or a culto or something. It is a group. No. Born again is an experience. Yung experience na yun is the time when you got saved. When you accepted in your heart the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, that is the time you are born again. So all of you here, na if you claim that you have accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, you are born again. Alright, so Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he is old? Tama ba naman, you know? Paano ay sisilag kung matanda na? Diba, laki mo na, sisilag ka ulit? Yan ang tanong eh. Yan ang pag-isip ng tao. And actually, practical yung kwa niya eh. Because before, they don't know about this born of the Spirit or born again. So, sabi, can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, verily, verily. No? Inulit talaga. Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Unless you are born again, you cannot go to heaven. If you ask me, ibig sabihin pala, kapag hindi po ako na-born again, wala, hindi kami pupunta sa langit. Yes. If someone asks you, are you born again? Yes, I am born again. Diba? Hindi yung born again na religion, yung experience. Ako ay isinilang ng muli. Kaya, nakakapanglungkot because many, especially Filipinos, they say that if born again. No. Ang born again tayo. Anyone who accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as their Lord and personal Savior is born again. Okay? Sabi pa dyan, that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that is born of the Spirit is Spirit. Now that you have the Holy Spirit in you, you have, ano yung kanina yung una natin? Fruit of the Spirit. So before you will have the fruit of the Spirit, you must first have that Spirit. Now, this one, if you remember Pastor Pason quoted to us, the three sa buhay natin, we have this flesh, we have your soul, and then your spirit. Now, if you did not accept, wala ka pa pong Kristo sa buhay mo, or you did not have this experience of born again, or hindi mo pa tinatanggap si Jesus Christ bilang iyong Panginoon at tagapagligtas, you only have two, and that is your flesh, and that is your soul. Your spirit is dead. The Bible says that we are dead in trespasses and sins. That's why your spirit is dead. Kahit po anong gawin natin. And the Bible also says that, as it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. So, that is our status that time before we got saved. We are dead in trespass. But when you accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, you have the new spirit. Mayroon ka ng espiritu. Nabuhay po yung espiritu na nasa yun. So, you have three. Now, if you have in heaven, we're talking about eternal life and heaven. In heaven, if you don't have the spirit, hindi ka makapunta ng heaven because heaven is a spiritual thing, spiritual place. How would a guy who doesn't have a spirit would go to heaven? Yun lang po, ganun lang po yung langit. No? Hindi ka po makapunta ng langit if you don't have the Holy Spirit within you. Alright. Ngayon, you are born of the Spirit. Now, nakita natin, if itong si Nicodemus, I hope you should understand this, that this Nicodemus, nakita niya, he realizes because Jesus Christ is preaching also at the synagogue, no? Nag-preach Jesus Christ, eh, no? Hindi pa siya pinagbabawalan. And this Nicodemus maybe had listened to him because he called Jesus Christ as a teacher. Now, Nicodemus realizes yung need niya. Imagine, you are rich, you are influential, you are, he is even respected as a religious man. So he doesn't need anything actually at that moment in his life. But he realizes that something is missing. Something is missing in his life. And that is the thing na na bumabagabag sa kanya. That's why he approaches Jesus. And that is the thing also is true to each and everyone. You have that feeling na something is kulang. Bakit ang lalaki nagbababae? Something is kulang sa kanya. Hinahanap niya yung kulang. Saan pupunta? Pupunta sa beer house. Right? Kung masaya yan, hindi yan pupunta ng beer house. Bakit ang isang hindi mananampalataya, kailangan pa niyang uminom, alright, para maging masaya? Because something is missing in his life, and that missing link is yung spirit mo. Parang may butas sa puso ng mga hinahanap mo, parang may kulang sa buhay ko, parang may lagi kang hinahanap na hindi mo naman mahanap. And we at that time as unbelievers, I experienced that, we tend to resort to drinking, maybe taking drugs, okay, go to places like this and that. But still, pagising mo, still something is missing in your life. And that missing link is the spirit. And that only can be filled by the Lord Jesus Christ. So, now, first thing, ano pong kailangan natin? You should be born again. I hope you understand how to be born again. No, like the life of Nicodemus, he realizes his need. Hindi niya kayang iligtas ang sarili niya. He cannot save himself. Even all of these things that he has riches, he has money, he's a religious guy, he follows the Ten Commandments. Okay, mabait siya. Kung tutusin, mabuti siyang tao. Nagbibigay yan ng tithes. Alright? The Bible, in the Old Testament, these Jews are very faithful in giving their tithes and offerings. But something is missing. At na-realize na, doon sa verse, sa 3:15, sa 3:15, sabi niya, sa 3:15, sabi po niya, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have eternal life. Ayun po yun. Yun po yung last na sinabi. So if you are in 6, just scroll down, makikita nyo sa verse 15. Whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And sinong kanino siya? Believeth in Him. In whom? The Lord Jesus Christ. Right? By faith, we are saved. Right? So yun po ang kaligtasan. Ang kaligtasan, ang the salvation, what we believe and what the Bible says, you cannot have eternal life if you cannot be saved by your works. Diba? Sa Ephesians 2:8-9, for by grace are ye saved, not of your works. Ano sabi yan? Not of yourselves. It is the gift of God. Bakit? Sabi niya dun, kasi kapag ang sarili mo, ikaw, dahil nasave ka, dahil mabait ka, pagyayabang mo yan. Ay, kasi mabait ako, kaya siguro pumunta ako ng langit. Hindi po eh. Hindi po yun yung prinsipyo na yung turo na binibigay ko sa atin ng Bible o ng banal na kasulatan. Alright? So first thing, you must be born again. I believe all of you here are born again. Amen po ba?
Amen.
Amen. Alright? So, when you are born again, ang sabi dun sa, if you scroll down in this verse, I like this chapter actually, no? John chapter 6. Ang sabi niya dyan, kasi kinumpel niya eh, paano mo nalalaman ang isang tao na born again? Paano mo nalalaman? I cannot tell now by just seeing you or observing you na masasabi ko na kayo ay born again. Sabi po dyan, sa John, sabi sa John 3. Okay. Sa verse, okay, verse 8. Alright. Sabi niya, the wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but canst not tell whence it cometh, and whither it goeth. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. So, ibig sabihin, hindi mo po makikita, o sabi natin, hindi mo malalaman, no, kung born again ba yan o hindi. But you can notice the effect of being a born again. Yan po yung sinasabi niya. Kasi kapag humangin, di mo alam, nasan ba yung hangin? Dito, may hangin dito, pero di mo nakikita, di ba? Pero kapag binubuhan kita, bumaho, sabi. Pag binubuhan kita, gumalaw yung buhok mo, alam mo na may hangin. Yun po yung epekto ng hangin. Nung bumaga ka, yung yung buhong gumalaw. O kahit kapag gumahin sa labas, ang hangin, yung mga dahon-dahon, gumagalaw, di ba? Alam mo na may hangin, may epekto. Ganon din sa isang born again. If you are really born again, may epekto yan sa buhay mo. Right? Naiintindihan mo ba natin? Ang pagiging born again, may effect sa buhay po natin. Hindi po born again, okay, born again ako, okay. So wala na, ano nangyari? Ano na bago sa'yo? Anong epekto ng pagiging born again sa'yo? Diba? Ganun po yung sinasabi rito. Kapag tinuloy nyo po yan, 6, 7, 8, verse 8, diba? May pagbabago po yan. Alright. So yan ang pagiging born again. Now, next, paano to tayo makakapunta sa pagiging long and lasting gentleness? Next, anong next? Yan. He must be born again. Okay? You cannot grow. Sabi mo kanina, di ba? We should understand this in the context of growth. Right? You cannot grow unless there is a seed na punla na nandun. Diba? Kailangan mo na meron. You should be born first bago ka. Ang bata, hindi yan lalaki. Anong lalaki? Saan ang lalaki kapag wala mo nang sinisilang, di ba? Ganun po yan kasi you must first. Kaya yan po yung first requirement. That is the first requirement. And I believe that is the most important thing that any person in this room should know. You must know how to be born again. Okay? Alam natin kung paano ba isilang ulit. Now, next. First was just a claim. Then, the next is living in the Spirit. Open your Bibles, alright? Galatians 5:25. Although nandyan po sa harap, I'd like you to open it so that you can mark your Bibles. Galatians 5:25 says, if we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Now, ito ang tanong eh. What's the sense of you being saved or born in the Spirit if you are not living in the Spirit? What's the sense? Saved ka nga. Pero, ano nangyari, di ba? Ngayon, ito yung magandang example eh, sa doon sa nabasa mo. Sabi niya, kapag bumili ka ng bahay, di ba, may bahay ka na, right? Mga OFW, mahilig bumili ng lupa, bahay yan, no? If you have a house, then you'll get a title, of course, right? Or your certificate of your ownership, right? You'll get the title. Now, you own that house, right? So that is, you can say you are born of the Spirit. Kung compare po natin, ano? And living in the Spirit, now that you own the house, you now live in the house. It's all different than just claiming the house and then living in the house itself. Diba? Magkaiba po yun eh. So, ang tanong po dyan, where do you live right now? Saan po ba tayo tumitira? And Bible says you should go where the Spirit lives. And where the Spirit lives? Sa buhay ng mga mananampalataya. Nasaan ang mga mananampalataya? They are in the house of God. So I would encourage you, anytime na mayroon tayong service, you should come to the church. Because the Bible says, live in the Spirit. And how would you live in the Spirit if you have more time going to malls? Do you think God is there? Of course God is there, but is God living in the malls? No. God lives in the house of God, in the church. And the church composed of the persons who accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as their Lord and personal Savior. So you should live in the Spirit. In the sense that sana tayo, we should saturate ourselves by the Word of God. Kaya mamuhay tayo sa Espiritu. Hindi po yung, we should not, no, lagi nating hawak ang cellphone natin, di ba? Facebook. Yung Facebook, if you try to do the Facebook every day, you cannot see the ending of it. Nasaan na yung nakita ko lang kahapon? Parang ang dami na naman nag-post, di ba? Diba? Pag nag-Facebook ka, you notice it. And then you will not notice that you spend maybe 2 hours, 3 hours, right? And you're doing your Facebook and your daughter or your son is there crying. He's still Facebook parang na parang nagre-re. Di ba? O yung yung asawa mo o yung ano mo, hindi mo na pinapansin. Especially kapag nag-lagay tayo ng Facebook, wala ka ng time to saturate yourself with the Word of God. Sino mo ba dati dito ang nagbabasa everyday ng Bible? Wala! You are here to learn, and I hope you should learn to read the Bible, di ba? Sabi that you should live in the Spirit. So next, anong susunod? Susunod na ba dyan yung fruit? After living in the Spirit, nandiyan na ba yung fruit kagad? No? Actually, this outline, I got this from when I was back in the Philippines, from San Fulano. Kaya pag umuwi kayo, sulat niyo yung mga outline, no? Especially good messages. Alright? And I was blessed with this, huh? With this outline when I heard this message. Right? Next, sabi pa dyan, sabi pa sa 8:28-2, sabi, "For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus hath made me free from the law of sin and death." For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus. Tayo po dapat mabuhay sa Espiritu. Alright? Next is walk in the Spirit. This I say, sa Galatians 5:16, walk in the Spirit and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. The lust of the flesh. Ano ba yung lust of the flesh? Diba? Ang dami yan. Kaya naalala yung binasa natin kanina? Sa 5, babalik nyo sa 5, Galatians 5, nandun po yung lahat ng halos lahat ng kasalanan. Eh. Dami, no? Those are the lust of the flesh. Now, walk in the Spirit. Kanina, we are born of the Spirit. Next, we live by the Spirit. And then, secondly, and third is, walk in the Spirit. No, ano yung pagkakaiba nito? No, as you saturate yourself with the Word of God, as you try to live in the Spirit, tinatry mo na ipamuhay, yung walk, yung naririnig mo. Yung walk mo, yung napapakinggan mo sa Bible, sa printing, you try to walk that. Try to gawin mo, no? Na makita sa paligid mo yung ginagawa mo na nakabase sa Word of God. Alright, so we, sabi natin, I saved now, okay na, okay na. Anong sense? Ito ang laging tanong, anong sense ng pagiging isang born again mo o isang mananampalataya mo? O sabi mo, I am a follower of the Lord Jesus Christ, but look at my life. Diba? Tingnan mo yung buhay niya. You see, makikita mo ba na namumuhay ang Espiritu sa kanya? Or do you see the Lord Jesus Christ in his life? Mahirap, di ba? Pag ganun, alright? So walk in the Spirit. Ipamuhay mo, ilakad mo. Ilakad mo kung ano yung natututunan mo sa Bible. Ilakad mo kung ano yung naririnig mo sa preaching. Alright? Hindi po yung, wala eh, narinig. Parang wala eh, no? Dumaan na ako na, ano yun? Ano yun, di ba? Ah, sorry ah, kung medyo harsh ako. Pero, ganun po talaga, no? It is the Word of God. Alright? And this one, if you really want to have that fruit of the Spirit, there's no shortcut. Amen. You cannot have shortcut. I will say, you will wait. Maybe you'll have a gentleness for some couple of hours or days, but it will not last. It will not last. And you will only have this one by following all these stages or this progress in your spiritual life. Walk in the Spirit. What's next? Yeah, I would like you to read this one. Romans 8:4-6. If you have the Bibles, open it. Have you? That the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For they that after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they that after the Spirit the things of the Spirit. Your flesh wants to do things outside the church. Your flesh wants to go to city center, go to the movies, kain-kain. That is your flesh. Your flesh wants you to be in the bed till 10 o'clock in the morning, sleeping. That is your flesh. But your spirit that will not always agree with that. Tama mo ba? Your spirit wants you to be in the church. Your spirit wants you to read the Bible. Your spirit wants you to pray. Yan po yung spirit. Not you fulfill the lust of your flesh that ayaw mo church kasi gusto kong pumunta lang ba eh. Sale sa city center. Sale daw sa city center eh. Na nagsabi sa akin kami, kung sale sa city center, bumili na kayo ng regalo. Kasi malapit ng Christmas. O nga, no? Pwede. Pero, that is the last of the flesh. Right? Going to the Bible study rather than going to, let's say, saan ba kayo pumunta pag weekdays? Punta uli sa mall, no? Mall lang na pumunta mo rito, di ba? You go again to the mall instead of going to the Bible studies. Right? Okay, that is the last of the flesh. Or, example lang, men, if you are choosing a woman, you will fulfill the lust of your the flesh and your eyes. You will look into a woman that is beautiful, sexy. But if you always forget to fulfill the yung spirito mo. Ano bang gusto ng spirito mo? Your spirit wants a partner in your life that is also spiritual. Right? He is a faithful sa church, faithful to God. Right? That is what your spirit wants. And the same thing sa ladies, guwapo kasi. Diba? Ang guwapo kasi. Diba? Ganun ang ladies eh. Ewan ko lang ha. I don't know, but most of the ladies, ang cute-cute naman nito eh. Tingin mo pa sa... But actually, I was so surprised yesterday because we have a local Katari colleague, no? And there are ladies talking, we have some small snacks in the, and then I just passed by and then this Katari lady is looking at the picture of what? No, this is more handsome than kumpira, pati itong mga Katari pakumot-kumot pa kayo ng muna, di ba? They also are having this thing na they want to fulfill their lust of the flesh. And that is, sabi natin sa na ikaw na nasa flesh na to, that is there in you. Because the Bible says, if anyone be in Christ, he's a new creator. All things are passed away. All things are passed away. Now, yung old nature mo nandiyan pa rin, still there, right? But we should always fulfill the last of this belief. Alright? So next, now as you walk, anong susunod? What's next? Should be led by the Spirit. Ano yung led by the Spirit? Ilaw ba yan? Ilaw. TV ba yan? TV? LED, ano? Led by the Spirit. In Galatians 5:18 says, but if ye be led of the Spirit, ye are not under the law. Now, how is it? After you try to walk, no? Try to walk the Spirit is leading you to where you should be. Alright? Maybe you're asking, but parang hindi ako away. I cannot see the leading of the Spirit to me, or I cannot see the leading of God to me. Maybe you are not walking in the Spirit for someone, or maybe you are not living in the Spirit, or maybe you are not born again. Yan po yan. It all goes back to the first. First thing that you should always say, am I really saved? Saved ba talaga ako? Because sometimes it comes in our life na saved ba ako? You tend to ask yourself, di ba, na saved ba ako? Kasi ba't ganito yung buhay ko? Di ba? So, as you walk, ye are led by the Spirit. In Romans 14:17, sabi dyan, for as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Are you a son of God?
Amen. Amen.
Okay, so tayo po ay nililid na Diyos, nililid na Espiritu, where we should be. For ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself bearing witness with our spirit that we are the children of
God. Sa atin
that we are really the sons of God. As you walk in your spiritual life, as you are led by the Spirit, nakikita po yan na ang Espiritu na nasa sa iyo ay totoo, na nandyan si Jesus Christ sa buhay po natin. And if children, then heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if so be that we suffer with Him, that we may also be glorified together. One day, alam ko mahirap po maging isang mananampalataya. Marami pong mahirap po yan. I would not say na madali. Of course, you have that joy always in your heart if you are serving God and all these things. But one day, isipin na lang po natin that one day we will also be glorified in heaven. Kasama natin si Jesus Christ. And sabi nga sa Bible that no more tears. No? Wala nang sakit. No? Wala nang arthritis. Wala nang sakit ng ipin. No? Wala na ka ng sakit eh. Sarap no? Guwapo ka na siguro dun. Maganda ka na siguro dun. Kahit na guwapo ka ngayon, mas guwapo ka dun. Di ba? Maybe ngayon, malaki ang tiyan mo. Dun, abs na. Di ba? Sabi ko, you will have a glorified body. Di ba? You will have a glorified body up there in heaven. And remember this, when we will come back, no, after we are in heaven, kailangan maging pante, fit ka eh. Why? Because babalik tayo. Di ba? Umamarcha tayo. At makikipagpan tayo. Hindi tayo mawawala kasi glorified body. Makikipagpan ka sa mga unbelievers, di ba? Yun ang sabi ng Bible. That maybe you have not reached that in the Bible, but that will happen. That will happen. When you are in heaven, that will happen. And then you will live. You will walk in the streets of gold. Diba? You will have fruit, that a tree that bears lots of fruit. No? Imagine mo na lang yung heaven. Dito, doon, nilalagay mo lang sa iring mo, sa singsing. Doon, inaapakan mo. No? Ganun po ka kaganda sa langit. At in contrast, if you are going to hell, we cannot describe the sufferings that will have in hell. Hindi po sa tinatawag kayo, but hell is really not a good place for you to stay. Right? If here it is 55 degrees, there you will be burned. Yeah? And then, there's no light. Imagine. I don't know, mainit eh. It's hot and all. Where is that coming from? No? Black fire siguro, no? Is there a thing that called black fire? They will ihawin ka parang litson. Diba? That is hell. And it's not, siguro walang sense naman kung gusto mong pumunta ng hell against heaven. Diba? And I believe that's why you are here today, because you also want to know how to go to heaven. And you want to know na, diba, hell ganito, heaven, and something in your heart na sabi mo na may kulang, kaya ka nandito eh. And then something, sa mga believers, you know, that the Spirit is telling you that you need to come to church. Now, led by the Spirit, susunod na, no? Susunod na ba yan? Fruit of the Spirit na ba? As you are led by the Spirit, ano susunod? Next is the manifestation of the Holy Spirit. Now you are born again. Okay, next is you are living the Spirit. You are walking the Spirit. I would ask you, nasaan na po ba tayo ngayon dito? Are we in this stage, walking the Spirit or living the Spirit? Alright? And next is led by the Spirit, and now the manifestation of the Spirit. Okay. Now, as we lead, no? As we are led by the Holy Spirit, now you are walking. God is leading you to something. God is leading you to maybe serve God. And as He leads you, He will equip you. And manifestation of the Holy Spirit means God is giving you gift. Binibigyan po tayo ng kakayahan. Binibigyan ka po ng wisdom on how to deal with that person, on how to share the word of God. Do you think I am here dahil I studied in a very high, you know, caliber na college, no? When I first stand in front, I almost collapsed. Parang wala pang 1 minute, tapos na yung pagtayo mo dito, parang gusto ko na umupo. And as you are led by the Spirit, He will equip you. Now, I can speak in English. Before, only Ilocano. I can only speak Ilocano and Tagalog. Tagalog, pabudol-tudol pa. Now, at least I can speak in English. And do you understand my English? Alright? I hope so, because you are from Philippines. And my friend, I hope you understand my English, my accent. It is called the Ilocano accent in Philippines. Alright, so now, in 1 Corinthians, how God equips you. Ano ba yung binibigay sa atin? Buksan mo natin. 1 Corinthians chapter 12.
7 to 11.
Diyan na po kayo? Alright, diyan din sa harap yan. Sa John, I'll deliver you. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to profit. Right? We should understand this. It is written to the church of Corinth. Right? We should understand this in the context of the church also. Right? Kasi sinulat to, it is written to the church of Corinth. Now it says there, but the manifestation of the Spirit is given to everyone to profit with that. Para po tayo makinabang sa binibigay nito sa church. Alright, now, for to one is given by the Spirit of the word of wisdom, to another the word of knowledge by the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another the gifts of healing by the same Spirit, to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another discerning of Spirit, to another diverse kinds of tongues, to another interpretation of tongues. But all these worketh that one and the self same Spirit, dividing to every man severally as He will. Now the same Spirit, only one Spirit that gives to us, He gives us gift to everyone. So one guy, maybe he's receiving a gift of wisdom, right? One guy, maybe a gift of teaching, right? Discipling. One member of the church, maybe having the gift of very, he has this charisma or to invite people, right? Maybe some of him have this gift of cleaning, alright? Cleaning the villa, cleaning, alright? So, all of us here, we are one, and we are working all together to profit with us. Para yung church, sabi natin, magpatuloy na maayos. Alright? Lahat po tayo binigyan po dito ng gift. Another verse, Romans 12:6-8, sabi dyan, having then gifts differing according to the grace that is given to us, whether prophecy, alright, let us prophesy according to the proportion of the faith. So prophesy meaning preaching, right? We prophesy, we preach the word of God. That's the meaning. Hindi po yung prophesy na magsasabi ako rito that Jesus will, Christ will come tomorrow. No, hindi po, no? Prophesy those things that will come as the Bible teaches us. And we know that Jesus Christ will come soon, but we don't know the day, but He will come soon. Right? Or minister, let us wait on our ministering, or he that teacheth on teaching. Alright, so may mga, we have some brethren here who are gifted with discipleship or teaching abilities. Right? They will disciple person. And I was with the two young men here. He is sharing the word of God, and I was so surprised. No, how he shared the word of God. He is so calm. Gusto mo po bang, he is so calm, and even me, I want to really hear what he says, because you know, Bible po yun eh. As I watch him, and I am so blessed na nandun ako ng North End. Ano, bata pa lang, no? Okay, sana nga lahat tayo, no? Meron po tayo silbi dito. Straight na to eh, no? Kasi lahat po tayo, born, we are born again. No? Sabi dyan, lahat po dapat kung ikaw ay born again, you should have that desire also to be involved in any of the ministries that are here. Right? There we have AB. If you have the choir, you should be involved. We have ministry of cleaning. Cleaning is a ministry. Right? All of this, ushering is a ministry. Gatekeeping is a ministry. Lahat po na yan, bagay na yan. We should be involved. Kung tatanong pa tayo, what is our role? No? Dito, ano ang role mo? Ano ba binigay na keep sa'yo ng Diyos? I'll may keep siguro, but madala akong antok eh. So every time you are in the church, you are sleeping. So that is your gift. Ang hindi maganda, no? Or maybe God give you a gift of having a big stomach. Mahilig kumain, you give me the gift of appetite. So yun ang role mo. Is it what the God of the Bible says? No. It's like the working of the body. Lahat po yan, may silbi. As the Bible says that we are like the body. Right? The eyes cannot work against the hands. So they should help each other. The ears also. They have all their purpose kung bakit po nandyan. Right? And that is the manifestation of the Spirit. Or he that exhorted on exhortation in preaching, he that giveth, let him do it with simplicity. Right? So, marami sa, I hope you are involved in here. We have the ministry also of giving. Right? Where does our giving goes? It goes to maintaining this villa, goes to Cambodia, to the other parts of the world. We give to para ma-spread pa po yung word of God. Not only here in Qatar, but only in other parts of the world. And because that is what the Bible says. Right? So, yan. Give it, let them do it with simplicity. He that ruleth with diligence. Alright, so some of you have the gift of administration. Alright, so para maging maayos po itong panambahan po natin dito. So there are some people who are given this gift. Alright, he that showeth mercy with cheerfulness. Maybe some has a gift here that you give encouragement to other person. But kita mo siyang malungkot, you will come to him or to her, right? You'll give joy and gagalakin mo, patutuwain mo, patatawanin mo, tatambling-tambling ka dyan. It's a gift, di ba? Yan po yung sinasabi na gift. And we should all be involved in him. Alright?
Right.
You have a car, why not join our transport ministry? Diba? You have gift of singing, why not join the choir? If you have time, wala kang pasok, come here on Thursdays and join the choir and sing for the Lord. We have lots of ministries and that is the manifestation of the Spirit. Now, ito na, pinakain tayo. The next part is, now we are here, fruit of the Spirit. Paano nagpunta dyan? Parang biglang fruit, manifestation. Now, ganito po kasi yan. If you are serving God, if you involve yourself in the ministry and start serving the other people or start serving other brethren, this is the time you will develop all this fruit. Doon madidevelop all this fruit. And as you, apag nandito ka, no? Let's say, for example, when I joined the transport ministry, I developed the fruit of patience. In Doha, I don't have any problem. But back there in Dubai, I have a really big problem. I was driving the H1, the Hyundai, and there are some people, you texted them and called them, I will come and pick you up at 8:30. Alright, sige brother, okay, we'll be ready by 8:30. You're there at maybe 8:20 and she or he is not ready. Then, okay, 8:30. So, at that time, if God will not equip you with this manifestation of the Spirit or the gift that He will give you, sa tingin mo po ba, you will develop that kind of patience na meron ka ngayon. Kasi, as you serve other people, doon mo ma-realize that you really need patience in all of this. Lahat, gentleness. At 8:30 na, wala pa. Sige po, balikan ko na lang po kayo. Ikot. 9:30 na, wala pa. Start na ng service. Oh, bihira naman. Sarap pa po ganito. Diba? You will develop, but you cannot say that. You will not say to that. Because you should be gentle. No? You should be gentle to your brethren. Maybe you don't know the reason, diba? You don't know the reason behind why he or she is late. Maybe he's still sleeping. Diba? Napuyat siya. Diba? Kaka-Facebook. You don't know the reason. Diba? But you should be gentle. And yun po yung context ng growth. You cannot have shortcut that immediately after I receive Jesus Christ as my Lord and personal Savior, I'll have this fruit of the Spirit. No. Hindi po ganun. So, makukuha nyo po ito, the true and lasting gentleness and all this fruit of the Spirit, if you start serving God. If you start involving yourself and experience all of this, na po kung paano mag-serve sa Diyos. And that time, you will have the fruit of the Spirit. Because fruit of the Spirit comes from God, always comes from God. You cannot do it with yourself. Hindi ko, lagi pong tatandaan yan. You cannot do it yourself. It always comes from God. And that fruit from born of the Spirit, living the Spirit, walking in the Spirit, and led by the Holy Spirit, and as the Spirit give you gift, at that time, doon ka po madidevelop this fruit of the Spirit. Di po shortcut yan. No? Brad, pag-pray mo ako, sana magkaroon ako ng fruit of the Spirit. Sige, Brad, pag-pray kita. The next day, tatanungin ka niya, Brad, wala pa. Ano yun? Parang, ganoon na lang, no? It passes this progress or the stages of your Christian life. You cannot have that. I would say that it's also my experience that when you start serving God, start involving yourself in the ministry, doon mo na madidevelop yan. Doon mo na madidevelop yung those sinasabi nila that you should always put God first. As before yourself, you always do these things para sa Panginoon. Alright? So, that is the fruit of the Spirit. Now, gusto nyo pa po ba magkaroon ng fruit of the Spirit? Do you still want? Mahabang proseso, ano? Alright? So, tayo po tayo lahat as we close with this conclusion. Alright? In conclusion, you are born again, you are born of the Spirit. Live in the Spirit, walk in the Spirit, led by the Spirit, manifestation of the Holy Spirit, and the last, the fruit of the Spirit. And that is the time you will have this virtue of gentleness. And all comes with it, all the fruit of the Spirit, the love, joy, peace, long-suffering, temperance, goodness, gentleness. Alright? So, I would like you to bow your head. I will go to the Lord in prayer. Before that, I want to ask you, saan na po ba kayo? Nasaan na po ba kayo sa progress or this stage ng isang mananampalataya? I would ask you this question right now. Kung hindi ka pa po ba, if you have not accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, it is the time for you to accept. Now is the day of salvation, sabi nga po ng Bible. You have not accepted and you don't know if you're going to heaven if you die today. You should accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. Sino po dito ang hindi pa po na tumatanggap sa kay Jesus Christ bilang kanyang tagapagligtas? Who here wants to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as his Lord and personal Savior? You can raise your hand and we will pray for you. Is there anyone? Is there anyone who would like to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as his Lord and personal Savior? Huwag po kayo maya. If you are not sure if you're going to heaven or not, I would ask you to raise your hand and we will share to you on how to go to heaven. Anyone here? Meron po ba? Alright, so sa ating mananampalataya na nandito ngayon, nasaan na po ba tayo? Nasaan na po ba tayo sa stage na to? Yes, you are saved, no? You claim that you are saved. Live in disobedience. And the first thing na dapat gawin po na isang mananampalataya who accepted the Lord Jesus Christ is to obey God in the water of baptism. That is your first step in your obedience to God. Anyone here who wants to follow Christ in the water of baptism, mayroon po ba dito? Is there anyone here who wants to follow Jesus Christ in the Lord of baptism? Mayroon po ba? Anyone who wants to be baptized? Anyone? Alright, so you are now living in the Spirit. How is your walk? How is your walk? Are you just attending this church? Are you just a regular attendee of this church? Why not walk in the Spirit? And others may know that you are a believer. Alright, I would encourage you that as you grow, mayroon po sanang pagbabago sa buhay natin. Mayroon po sanang progress sa buhay natin. And I would encourage you, if you don't have a ministry tonight, today, pray to God that He will lead you to that ministry and give you gift on how to be involved in that ministry. Okay, let us pray. Dear God in heaven, if I thank the Lord for your word, I just pray, oh God, that the preaching may bunga po sa aming buhay, oh God. And as we depart in this place, may you dismiss us with your blessing, oh God, and bless the remaining part of our service. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, you may be seated.
Okay, time for you
mag-sit
tayo, at we will sing our closing song. Sing victory in Jesus.
Oh, Father, Lord God, thank you for your presence and the victory sa katapos po namin yung worship service. Panginoon, dito po sa Doha, sa Katapapong Car Stations, Lord God. Truly, napakabuti niyo po sa buhay namin, Panginoon, as we have the privilege again to hear the words. Thank you for using Preacher Frank to deliver the words. Panginoon, it's our prayer na hindi lamang po namin ito narinig or napakinggan, but ito po ay aming naunawaan, Panginoon, and mostly ito po ay aming maisabuhay according to your will and plans. Lord, give us a gentle heart and teach us how to be gentle to other people as well. Lord God, help us that you may give the fruit of the Spirit, that it will dwell in us, Panginoon, and as a believer, teach us to live and walk in the Spirit, at ito po ay aming makita sa buhay, Panginoon God, bilang mananampalataya. Lord God, tulungan niyo po kami na hindi manghina, but instead help us na ma-encourage pa po ang bawat isa to continue serving you, especially in your ministry, Panginoon. Lord God, you will lead us into a right path, Panginoon. Lord, continue bless us and use us as a blessing to other people, especially those people na hindi pa po nakakilala sa inyo, Panginoon. Lord, I continue pray as we depart this place temporarily. Kaya po ay patuloy na mag-ingat sa bawat isa, Panginoon, until we will reach home safely. And for our remaining activities, Panginoon, give us the continuing strength and guidance, Panginoon, with your guiding spirit, be upon us always, Lord God. And I continue to pray for the food that we're about to partake, Panginoon. Bless niyo po ito, bless niyo po ito, Panginoon. Na ito po yung magbigay ng kalakasan and nourishment sa aming pangatawan, Panginoon. Bless those hands na nag-prepare nito, Panginoon, as you bless us. Lord, maraming salamat po for this overflowing blessings na nawisig po namin sa araw-araw. Panginoon, Lord, thank you for everything. We give you back all the glory and praises. In Jesus' name, everybody say, Amen. God bless us all. Fellowship to each other. Give a smile to everyone. And we have a song that's lunch outside.